most dog owners would have learnt in puppy school that the way we get a dog to do something that we want is by rewarding them for a behaviour with something that they want at the time they're demonstrating it. Think about when they're sitting or they're dropping in puppy school, what do? We reward them with a treat, a pat or praise when they're doing a behaviour at that time. That way the dog learns that it has good consequences, and as a result, it happens with more intensity and frequency. This brings me to a common problem behaviour though that we often therefore face is when we accidentally reinforce a behaviour that we don't want without even realising. We call this inadvertent reinforcement. An example of this is say when our dog is barking at us or when they're jumping up at us, often what we do is we bend down, we touch them, and what have we given them? Exactly what they want, your attention. Keeping this in mind, that's why it's really important to set the boundaries early as possible with our puppies. Even with older dogs, if you don't want them to be doing a behaviour, then make sure you're not reinforcing it without realising it. Set the boundaries nice and early and be consistent with them. Treats are a great way to do this because when your dog is at home, just day to day, you don't just have to use them in obedience training. You can have some little treats on hand, and then that way when they are displaying a behaviour that you want, nice, calm, sitting around, for example, you could give them a treat then by marking that behaviour, and that's the kind of stuff that you're going to see more from them because you're really marking and rewarding that. What we want to do, of course, then is we don't want to be rewarding when they are doing those jumps or those barks. We want to ignore that behaviour, and the moment they're going quiet or they've got all 4 feet on the ground, we reward them then. So that's why it's handy to have those treats. Milky sticks, for example, are great with puppies because they've got calcium in them, but also they break up really small. Chicken sticks for older dogs are great too because they can break up into small pieces. And then that way, if we've got a little pocket full, we're not going to be over-treating, but we're going to be able to reward that behaviour day to day that we want from them. Another important thing to remember when you're trying to set boundaries and not reward unwanted behaviour is to make sure everyone in the household is following the same rules. So if you don't want your puppy to be jumping up on the couch as an older dog or up on you, then you really shouldn't be encouraging it when they are a puppy. Again, it's really important that when we're using treats to reward our dogs, that we're not giving them more than 10% of their total calorie intake. We want to be responsibly treating for that good behaviour. And then another great thing as well is to use praise in between as well, just so that we're not always feeding our dog for behaviours that we want. For more puppy tips and information about treating responsibly, visit the VitaPet website.